At the start of the movie, we are introduced to a younger man named Bong. Bong is extremely gifted at cooking, and is the youngest chef in Blue Residence, that's the official residence of the South Korean Prime Minister. That evening, Bong learns that the residence is throwing a dinner party for a Chinese language ambassador. The ambassador is extraordinarily touchy to fishbone, so Bong is told to prepare a scrumptious fish dish with no bones. Bong heeds their preparation and right away starts preparing the dish. At nightfall, the dinner is ready, and served to the ambassador. Lamentably, as quickly as the envoy bites the fish, he finds a hook in it. This places Bong in an extreme quandary as several guards seek the mansion to find him. Within the following scene, a couple of police officers investigating the incident arrives at Bong's condo and knock on his door. Bong knows that he's in hassle, so he tries to break out through the balcony, even as the officers attempt their fine to catch him. Inside the procedure, Bong alas plunges into a swimming pool beneath, smacking his head on the bottom of the pool. For a few reasons, he maintains falling as a female swims toward him, and plant life a kiss on his lips. Whilst Bong wakes up, he finds himself on an abnormal mattress in a fair stranger room. Bong feels something is wrong and straight away rushes to a close by mirror. His mirrored image surprises him as Bong discovers that he has end up a female. He contemplates for a 2D, but finalizes that he ought to be dreaming due to the autumn. Bong creeps out of the room to determine out what's happening, but finds dozens of girls out of doors, who bow and discuss with her as, "Your Highness." Amazed by means of this, Bong runs outside the constructing, however all of sudden feels bloodless in her crotch. This is whilst Bong realizes that she has misplaced her banana. Bong is horrified through this and initially believes that she's been trafficked right into an intercourse change operation. But, while she observes his surroundings, Bong discovers that she time-traveled to the past. The belief causes her to go into surprise and she or he's finally delivered lower back to the palace. The next day, Bong wakes up and learns her modern identification from a maid. It turns out that she time-traveled to the Joseon dynasty, in the year 1851. Moreover, she now lives in the body of Kim So-yong, a royal ward. To make topics worse, Bong discovers that Kim is scheduled to marry the king and grow to be queen in a few days. The maid also explains that her body became located floating at the lake after an unknown coincidence took place. Luckily, the guards found and taken her return to the palace. Hearing this, Bong theorizes that each his and Kim's spirits must have switched, and infers that the price tag back domestic is the lake. Bong asks the maid to steer him to the lake as he plans to jump in and return to the prevailing. Sadly, her plan to jump takes an unexpected turn, as she lands on muddy floor. It seems that the Grand Queen ordered the palace servants to drain the lake overnight to prevent all of us from falling into the water once more. Bong is disheartened by way of the news but still reckons that water is the solution. So, she desperately attempts to submerge herself in any water supply she can find. She even is going as far as putting her head in a pail of water. This is used to ease the flooring. But, all her efforts prove abortive. Some days later, the wedding day arrives. Bong is unaware of the dynasty's customs but with the help of her handmaids manages to attire the specified wedding ceremony right. That night time, Bong, who is now queen, is invited to the king's chambers to sleep with him. Bong is horrified by way of the idea and offers the king a few alcohol in hopes of him passing out. Fortunately, the king sleeps off, a whole lot to Bong's alleviation. Day after today, Bong wakes up with a hangover and is obtainable a few food. However, she is disgusted through the soggy meal and passes a message to the royal chef to cook ramen alternative. The chef is stressed by means of the time period, but tries to make the foreign meal primarily based on Bong's instructions. The chef tries to make the dish a couple of times, but Bong is disillusioned with every stride. The primary dish is too healthful, at the same time as the subsequent dishes are too bland and spicy. Subsequently, the chef becomes disenchanted and gives up, asking Bong to cook it herself. Bong, remembering her culinary strategies, comes to a decision to prepare the dish. Bong enters the royal kitchen and right away chooses up a knife. Her maid concerns because the queen has in no way tried to prepare dinner on the grounds that adolescent. Therefore, the maid, along the opposite servants, expects her to make a mess of the kitchen. But, tons to the servants' marvel, Bong starts reducing the greens with fantastic speed and precision. She cuts the whole thing perfectly and on the proper length, ultimately, cooking an ideal dish. Bong takes the ramen lower back to her chambers and enjoys the meal with her right-hand maid. Returned in the kitchen, the chef is resentful of Bong's cooking competencies and proposes that the meal genuinely seems top but doesn't taste exceptional. To check his principle, the royal chef tries the leftovers ultimate within the pot. But, as soon as he has a chunk, he's surprised through how desirable it smiles that he even drops his spoon in shock. After the eventful stumble upon, Bong unexpectedly comes up with an idea. The new queen realizes that she will be able to without problems win over the royal family with her culinary abilities. The grand queen tired the lake. So, if Bong can please her with some food, she might agree to fill up the lake. Bong instantly returns to the kitchen. However, the jealous royal chef asserts his authority and refuses to let her inspect the food organized for the grand queen. Bong is pissed by means of this and challenges him to a velocity cooking contest. The royal chef first of all backs out from the combat, however accepts the task after Bong teases him. A servant rings a bell and the competition begins. The pinnacle chef takes his knife and viciously cuts a group of carrots. But the queen's fingers are faster and quick cut some cucumbers conveniently. After several minutes of cooking, Bong's dish is prepared and she or he is the primary to ring the bell, accordingly, winning the competition. The royal chef is pissed at this and argues that though velocity is vital, flavor is the final test of a chef's skill. Bong confidently is of the same opinion and requests the royal delicacies inspector to taste both dishes to look that is better. The inspector is curious about Bong's cuisine and announces it the higher dish, prompting her to take fee of the royal kitchen. Bong makes use of her newly acquired fame to her advantage, as she analyzes the grand queen's food. Bong discovers from her meal's choices that the grand queen is a choosy eater because of her current improvement of toothache. For that reason, Bong comes to a decision to make a meal with a gentle texture for the aristocrat. Bong gets to work right away and starts creating a potato porridge. First, she pours a few milk into the pot, and adds the proper ingredients, as she from time to time tastes the mixture. Then, the potatoes are finally delivered to the pot. After which, the dinner is served with a few flour toppings for a cohesive presentation. Bong is thrilled with the very last product and offers it to the grand queen herself. The queen substantially enjoys the meal but highlights that the dish isn't always best, because it arrived cold. The temperature change brought on the perfectly mashed potatoes to lump, hence, slightly altering the flavor. Also, the porridge spilled on the edges of the plate, which also affected the presentation. Bong is distraught to listen this and unfortunately starts her experience return to the palate. While in her carriage, Bong brainstorms on an opportunity means of handing over food to the grand queen. Quickly after, she comes up with a stellar concept. Bong sews a cloth, and has her maid supply the fabric along some commands to the royal engineers. With Bong's course, the engineers assemble a special meals transport carriage. This is nicely insulated on all aspects via the fabric. In the meantime, Bong prepares an array of tasty food and has the servants deliver them the use of the newly designed cupboard. The grand queen gets the recent meal, and enjoys it, leaving no leftovers. Ultimately, the engineers return to Bong and deliver the best information because the invention has proved to be a fulfillment. Some days later, the king organizes a big dinner party and invites delegates from all over the country. Alas, the chefs get sick on the dinner party day and the royal kitchen is short-staffed. Bong notices this and decides to help out. She sneaks out of the dinner party and enters the kitchen. Bong discovers that the pantry is low on ingredients, as the groceries supposed to be added that day couldn't make it. With restrained assets, Bong has no choice but to get creative. The queen, along her handmaids, prepares a easy however unique dish of potatoes. Bong peels and wraps the potato around a stick and deep fries it, making it crisp and crunchy. The guests are to start with unhappy after they see the first dish, as they anticipate something classier for a royal feast. However, as quickly as they are attempting the unique meal, their eyes shine in approval as they wonder at its flavor. Bong's 2D dish is a bit more tasking as there's no meat within the kitchen. She creatively makes use of beans to make a veggie burger with tomato. Have fun with on the aspect. Bong is thrilled with her invention and names it McDonald's, stimulated with the aid of the present-day McDonald itself. The dish, just like the potato serving, is a rec hit as the guests take pleasure in the mouth-watering cuisine. For the very last meal, Bong creates a conventional jelly dessert with a twist. She writes unique messages at the jelly sticks and calls them fortune jelly, as you get to read your fortune when you're carried out with the dessert. The guests revel in the classic jelly and have fun studying their respective fortunes. Notwithstanding the initial hiccups, the feast is a smash hit, thanks to Bong's cooking. The grand queen, who also attended the banquet, is inspired by using Bong's abilities and sooner or later asks her to make a request. With none hesitation, Bong asks to have the lake refilled. The grand queen presents her request and commands the servants to begin working on the job. Unluckily, as it is the 19th century, there aren't any superior machines to aid this undertaking. As a result, the servants can handiest shipping water manually with timber bucket. The technique is unbelievably sluggish because the servants make an extended ride from the metropolis as nicely to the lake. Bong is aggravated by way of this and swiftly comes up with a brand new approach. She asks each servant to stay at one spot and clearly skip the bucket from one man or woman to the other. The humans are thrilled with the gadget as it makes the process easier and faster. All of them keep the task and paintings on it patiently even as Bong oversees the prolonged procedure. Several days pass but the lake is yet to fill. Bong soon gets uninterested in waiting and turns into determined. Fortunately, a heavy downfall starts which slowly but steadily waters the lake. Bong is thrilled with the aid of the climate change and dances ecstatically under the rain. A few hours later, the lake is stuffed and Bong heads to the beaches and signs and symptoms her call on a cornerstone. After which, she jumps into the lake and sinks underwater, much like she did on the start of the film. While Bong wakes up, he is astonished to discover himself in a sanatorium and sees an officer sleeping some meters far from his bed. He quietly tries to slide out, however the officer wakes up and a speedy chase ensues. Bong manages to get away from him, however two more officers display up and nook him. Desperate, Bong jumps down from an excessive platform, escaping the guys as he races down the road. He at once heads to a public library and searches for a history ebook. There, he unearths a book approximately the Joseon dynasty and smiles, knowing that he has now become a component of history. However, his nostalgic ride down reminiscence lane is unexpectedly interrupted while the chasing officials arrive on the library. Bong tries to escape once more, however the officials give an explanation for that they aren't there to arrest him. It turns out that the existing has been changed because of his time journey to the Joseon generation. Now, he isn't always being chased by way of the police. As a substitute, they may be there to protect him as Bong is now a whistleblower and has uncovered an excessive rating reliable for corruption. Bong rushes to a close by computer and searches the internet to verify their claims. Quickly after, he discovers that they are telling the truth as history and the prevailing world have indeed changed. The movie ends with Bong's status on an avenue as he relays a fantastic message on how a small trade within the past can greatly affect the future.